Hey, we're all anticipating the release of the next standard iPad. The 10th generation should be showcased later during the year, probably in September. And while we already know some information, based on the leaks, there is still space for potential surprises. At one end, there were hopes for some display upgrades. Another, something more that it's hidden, the chip, for example. Hi friends, and welcome to this Digitalna channel. My name is Marko, and this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, tech rumors and reviews. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment below, hit the like button, and don't forget to enable all notifications so you don't miss the next video. This one is powered by MOFT. Check out their website and some of their awesome iPad, iPhone and MacBook accessories by following the links in the description and in a pinned comment. Get discount via Digitalna channel. Now, let's go. As title of this video suggests, the display will not be as much relevant subject here, although I do have to mention a couple of points. You all know that we have been listening about the increase of screen diagonal for a couple of years, and so far we haven't seen that promised 10.5-inch step up from current 10.2. In many ways, this doesn't seem to be crucial, comparable to lamination, for example, which can mean a bit of a difference while consuming content and using the device in general. But if we consider previous releases, maybe it's better not to assume anything, since Apple will do it or not. We can also get that famous laminated display while maintaining 10.2-inch screen size. Now, if you're overly optimistic, hoping for more than 60Hz refresh rate, you are in absolute science fiction zone, because this will not happen anytime soon, since Apple does not see it as essential for this product category. With that said, the internals are a completely different story. There were already some leaks pointing at Wi-Fi and Bluetooth improvements, while back in 2021 we already got ultra-wide 12-megapixel front-facing camera. Will Apple do something with the camera on the back, finally? I don't think so, since so far there was no urge to do that either. But what matters in the case of entry-level iPad is performance for the price. And so far, it has been the trademark of this very model. Opposite to previous upgrade cycles, both 8th gen and 9th generation iPad got the new chips, and no wonder why everyone is now expecting the new processor in its belly this year. So far, predictions have been suggesting the A14 like it's 100% certain, even if it truly isn't. Yet, I can relate to that, and I'm convinced that this chip will finally bring along 4GB of RAM as the next base standard for the iPad. With the latest iPad Air powered by the M1 and up to 8GB of memory, this shouldn't surprise, and it's without doubts. Yet there is another speculation that can be caught in tech community and among enthusiasts. The A15 Bionic has been a subject of expectations, and while this can be considered like too radical move for this type of device, supporters of such claim can just point fingers to the iPhone SE 3 and its specification. I'm not denying that possibility, even if this could be more kind of a big leap. However, this thinking requires a bit step in the past. There were situations when standard iPad got better chip than the flagship iPhone. Yes, the circumstances were much different back then, but that doesn't exclude possibility for now almost 1 year old chip, which already resides in entry-level iPhone, to land within the regular iPad. Now, if you're about to say, wait, the A15 Bionic is also at the core of the existing iPad mini, so you can't put the same chip? Well, we can. Since its predecessor, along with the iPad Air 3rd Gen, did share identical chip with 2020 iPad at one point. If we observe things in this way, anticipating the A15 shouldn't be something odd or too much. So anyone hoping to see this upgrade, keep it up, but be aware that your expectation may let you down eventually. Now you've been warned. The 10th generation iPad should also feature 5G support, but still it's not certain will there there be a price increase? If we take the new iPhone SE as the point of reference, price increase is almost inevitable. If we do get to see something as powerful as the latest Apple iPhone silicon, you can bet the iPad will cost more. Until then, we will follow closely what's going on, and in the fall, we will know the truth. What do you think? We will get the A15 at the core of the 10th-gen iPad? Please answer in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure you subscribe, hit the thumbs up and turn on notifications. Thank you so much for watching Digital Marketing channel. My name is Marco, talk to you soon, have an excellent day, bye.